In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Allison Roberta Wade died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. In baptism, Allison received the sign of the cross. May she now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant, Allison Roberta Wade, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Please be seated and listen to the word of God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, If I have all faith so as to move mountains but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices over the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. If there are prophecies, they will be brought to nothing. If tongues, they will cease. If knowledge, it will be brought to nothing. For we know partially, and we prophesy partially. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I used to talk as a child, think as a child, reason as a child. When I became a man, I put aside childish things. At present, we see indistinctly, as in a mirror, but then face to face. At present, I know partially, then I shall know fully as I am fully known. So faith, hope, love remain, these three, but the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord. I have come to believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. There are three things that last: faith, hope, and love. These three will take us to eternal life. That is our final goal in this life. In the first reading, we heard from St. Paul's discourse on love. That passage is her favorite passage. Yes. So, faith, hope, and love, they last forever. Faith in Jesus Christ. In the gospel we heard, "Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live." Because Jesus is the resurrection and the life. So believe in Jesus Christ. Have faith in Jesus Christ. That is why God the Father sent his only Son, Jesus Christ, into this world. Whoever believes in him will have eternal life. Amen? Amen. Do you believe this?
Yes.
So if you have faith, you will live forever. And the second one, hope. Hope for the eternal things. Hope for the resurrection of the dead. Hope for the second coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. St. Paul, in his letter to Titus, chapter 2, verse 13, "We are filled with hope. We wait the glorious return of our Lord Jesus Christ." We wait for his second coming. Amen? We need to be strong in our hope. We are going to receive those things. And finally, love. Jesus gave us the command, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind." Matthew chapter 22, verse 37. And he asked us to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. So, love of God and love of neighbor. This love will take us to eternal life. Love lasts forever. Amen? So that is why she chose that one as her favorite passage. And in the gospel, Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. So she had that faith in Jesus Christ. Allison, at very young age, died in Christ. God called her. And we read in the obituary, she lived her life to the fullest with love. Though her life is short, she lived it fully. A pleasing life to God, though short. Parents, relatives, friends, we have so many questions. God, why have you treated us like this? Why Ellie? Engage. Didn't we pray well? We prayed for her. Didn't we put our trust in God? Didn't we have faith in Him? Then why it happened? Why God took her at the young age? How many of you have these questions in your minds? How many of you? We have all these questions. Loving girl died at the very young age. Look at Jesus Christ. Look at Mother Mary. Jesus died on the cross at the age of 33. For the salvation of the world, God sent His Son, Jesus Christ. God willed that Jesus should die for the salvation of the world. And Jesus suffered and died on the cross. God sent Him on a purpose, and He fulfilled that purpose and died for all of us. Mother Mary might have asked, why my son at the young age? All these questions, we don't have answers, but we need to have faith in Jesus Christ. Allie was sent into this world for a purpose. We do not understand the will of God. She came into this world. She lived, we all believe, she lived her life fully and pleasing to God, not losing her faith in God, not losing hope. Because I was visiting her and talking to her, giving her all the sacraments, giving her communion, anointing of the sick, talking to her. She never lost her faith, her hope in her Savior Jesus Christ. We all believe that she is in the hands of God in eternal life. Amen? Do you all believe that?
Yes.
Yes. Sometimes, this type of situations, they shake our faith, our hope. Sometimes, we get angry on God, why God has done all these things. That is why St. Paul, in his letter to the Romans, he says, nothing can separate us from the love of God. Not anger, not angels or spirits, not present or the future, not powers above or powers below, hardships, peril, distress, death, the death of your sister, the death of your daughter, nothing will separate you and us from Christ. During these times, we need to be strong in our faith. We need to be strong in our hope in our Savior Jesus Christ. So, dear friends, family members, relatives, her schoolmates, we are all praying for her. We need to pray for her parents, siblings. The Lord strengthens all of us because His love endures forever. He loves us with eternal love. He protects us. When these things come, happen in our lives, we need to be strong. We should not lose our faith. We should not lose our hope. So, dear friends, we know that in life, in death, in life beyond death, God is with us. We are not alone. Don't lose hope. Don't lose your faith. Love your God. Love your neighbors. And let us continue to pray for the repose of Allison Roberta Wade and also for her family members and friends. Amen? Amen. Let us all stand and pray. Let us pray for Allison Roberta Wade, her family and friends, and for all God's people. For Allison Roberta Wade, child of God, that she be held securely in God's loving embrace now and for all eternity. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For Ali's family, especially her mother and father, her brother and sisters, that they feel the healing power of Christ in the midst of their pain and grief. We pray to the Lord. For Ali's friends, those who played with her and those who cared for her, that they be consoled in their loss and strengthened in their love for one another. We pray to the Lord. For all parents who grieve over the death of their children, that they be comforted in the knowledge that their children dwell with God. We pray to the Lord. For children who have died of hunger and disease, that these little ones be seated close to the Lord at His heavenly table. Let us pray to the Lord. For the whole church, that we prepare worthily for the hour of our death, when God will call us by name to pass from this world to the next. We pray to the Lord. Let us pray. Lord God, You entrusted Allison Roberta Wade to our care, and now You embrace her in Your love. Take her into your keeping, together with all children who have died. Comforters, your sorrowing servants, who seek to do your will and to know your saving peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of the name, for our good and all the church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Allison Roberta Wade, we beseech your mercy that she, who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful Judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise, as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Paul, our Archbishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Allison Roberta Wade, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us all stand and pray at the Savior's command, and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. All the Catholics, those who prepared themselves to receive the communion, please come forward. Others, please be seated and pray for her. Please be seated.
Good morning. I am Rodney Morris, Jenny's brother and Allie's uncle and godfather. It is so heartwarming to see the church filled with so many family and friends today. Allie touched so many lives in her short time on this earth. I asked Jenny if I could share a few words about what Allie meant to our lives. My first time holding her was when Dean and I were living in Dallas. The family came down for a visit about 6 weeks after she was born, and like all our nieces and nephews, it was love at first sight. I remember young Carly carrying Allie up the open wooden stairs in her socks. And of course, we were scared to death she was going to drop her. Fortunately, at least this time, she didn't. Over the years, and especially as a godparent, Dean and I have been honored and humbled to be in her life. We witnessed Allie grow into a beautiful young woman, full of life and witty comebacks. We sent a card and called for every holiday and birthday, as well as spending many Christmases with the family, ensuring she always received her Madame Alexander ornament series. And in the early years, we were big fans of her fashion shows at Christmas. Trying on her new outfits, she knew how to make an entrance. It's the little things that warm our hearts when we think of Allie. During our frequent phone calls, family trips, to see them and them to see us, and even as a pen pal, we heard from her firsthand what mattered to her. A recap at her day at school, who her favorite teacher and what her favorite class was. Talking about when she couldn't swim when she had an ear infection. Telling us what Eva and she were watching on Netflix. She always had a favorite. What her favorite book was. What mom was doing or not doing mom. What she was dressing up for as Halloween. An upcoming band performance or an FFA speech. About when she learned to drive a tractor at the farm. That was a proud day. Her most recent Oklahoma State sporting adventure, and she was a huge Cowboys fan, and even sending a kiss and hug for our dog, Mac. And we will always hold special the word awkward and the inside story that went with it. While she told us that she kept our postcards in a hat box with her most precious memories, we too kept her handwritten notes in a special place. When Allie was diagnosed with brain cancer or high-grade glioma during spring break of this year, Team Allie, her mom, Nathan, Carly and Carden, Eva and her dad fought valiantly in this quest to tackle this terrible disease. During these past months, we built on our many memories, living life to the fullest. Dean and I surprised her with an Oklahoma visit on a spring weekend. Allie, her mom, Allie's siblings spent time with us in Oregon during the summer, complete with a surprise visit from Carly and Carden. And we joined her on her Make-A-Wish trip to Alaska, cementing a lifetime of memories. With exemplary bravery and strength, Allie kept that beautiful smile as she showed us the true meaning of love, grace, and grit against all odds. Not only did Allie exhibit these characteristics, her mom, Jenny, led the charge for Team Allie. It was an inspiration to see a mother's love take charge, literally doing anything and everything she could for her daughter. We know that today and in the days to come, there will be hugs and there will be tears. There will be people who don't know what to say and some who can still make us laugh. There will be pictures and keepsakes, memories and stories, some we've never heard, and some we can never hear enough. There will be sorrow and there will be celebration, but most of all, there will be love, the kind that never ends. We are so grateful for the prayers, love, and support throughout her journey. To honor Allie and to keep her impact ever present, the family is establishing an endowed scholarship at Oklahoma State University in her name. Go Cowboys! And to celebrate and honor Allie, we ask you to join the family in the parish hall after today for a reception sharing your memories and stories of Allie. As I thought about Allie this week, there is a poem entitled "Don't Cry for Me," reminding me she is ever present. It goes like this. My body's gone, but my soul is here. Please don't shed another tear. Please don't shed another tear. I am still here. I'm all around. I am the snowflake that kisses your nose. I am the frost that nips your toes. I am the sun bringing you light. I am the sun bringing you light. I am the star shining so bright. I am the rain refreshing the earth. I am the laughter. I am the mirth. I am the bird up in the sky. I am the cloud that's drifting by. I am the thoughts inside your head. I'm still here. I'm all around. Rest in peace, sweet Allie. We love you.
Good morning. My name is Carly and I'm Allie's older sister. I asked my mom if I could say a few words today, and her response to me, she asked if I could do it, and I told her I would try. So please bear with me while I try, because I really want to do this for Allie. I have stood up at the front of this church three other times with Allie. The first time, I stood witness at her baptism. The second time, I had the privilege to serve as her sponsor for her confirmation, and I stood up at the front with her as she became confirmed. The third time, her and our other sister, Eva, they served as my ring bearers for my wedding, and they came up and handed me my rings on my wedding day. And now today is the fourth and final time I will stand up here with Allie. I remember being 8 years old, sitting in my third grade class at the Perry Elementary School, and the office made an announcement over the intercom, and they said, "We just wanted Carly Wade to know she's officially a big sister." Allie had entered the world. 2 years later, we got Eva, and the Wade siblings were complete. And in a small town like Perry, many people knew of the Wade siblings, even if just by our matching red hair. With a name like Allison, many nicknames were possible. My family primarily called her Allie, but from there, we got the name Allie Pally. That morphed into Pilly Pally, and I changed that to just Pilly, and then, maybe out of pure laziness, I ended up just calling her Pill. So that's what I called Allie, Pill. It sounds a little strange, and of course, after a few months of calling her Pill, my parents noticed, and they got on to me for calling her that, to which Allie said, "No, I like her when she calls me Pill." So it was solidified. She was my Pill. I wanted to share a few anecdotes about Allie and some of the special aspects about her that made her feel like sunshine. Allie was incredibly caring, not just for her family and her friends, but also with her animals, and especially if they were her animals. She loved her dogs, Nellie and Sparkles, and Allie was even the reason why my parents ended up with 18 kittens in their barn at one time. How do you get 18 kittens? Well, Allie's cat Legos had a litter, and then two of those kittens had their own litter shortly after, which resulted in 18 kittens, and you can bet Allie wanted to keep every single one of them. Allie was also a leader. She joined the Perry FFA in eighth grade, and at first begrudgingly agreed to participate in speech contests. Well, after a lot of practice, eventually Allie placed first in her speech category at the county level speech contest, and she advanced on to the next level, When she moved to Stillwater her junior year, she took a leadership class. I remember her and my mom calling me one day to tell me that Mrs. Phibbs, the leadership class teacher, had called my mom just to tell her how excellent of a public speaker Allie was. Allie was beaming, and we were so proud of her. Allie was also fearless. There's a picture hanging on my mom's fridge, and it's of Allie, Eva, and my grandma Mary Ann, and they're all riding the log ride at Frontier City. But you can't see my grandma or Eva's faces because they're ducked down hiding, but there's Allie in the front, her hands held high, and she's just having the time of her life. Because that was Allie, just fearless. When Allie was diagnosed back in March, she was fearless the whole way through. We never heard her complain or have self-pity, even though she had every right to. In fact, many nurses and doctors we met throughout Allie's treatments would tell us how much they liked Allie because she was so nice and polite, and sometimes even a little sassy, but in a good way. Every day we would ask Allie how she was feeling, and her notorious response was, "I'm okay," even though you knew she was experiencing an unmeasurable amount of pain. She would respond with, "I'm okay." Finally, my husband Cardin and I said to her, "Allie, you have to tell us how you're feeling so we can give you medicine to help you. So the new rule is you can't say I'm okay anymore." So Allie thought about it for a second, and then we asked her how she was feeling again, and she said, "I'm fine." She was strong, she was tough, and she was utterly fearless. Not too long ago, I was lying in bed with Allie, and I asked her why she loved the moon so much. And if you don't know, Allie loved the moon. She even named her car Luna after the moon. And her response to me was, "I like the moon because it's always going to be there up in the sky every night, no matter what. Even if you can't see it, the moon is always there." So as we all go our own ways today, I can confidently say that like the moon, Allie will always be with us. Even if we can't see her, she will always be there. Thank you.
Let us pray.
Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister, Allison Wade, may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please stand. She is fearless. At the age of 9, 10, in the second grade, third grade, my RE director was telling me she was asking her hardest questions. So my RE director answered her. So now she can ask Jesus all those questions in heaven. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In silence, let us pray for her. your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister, Allison Roberta Wade, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Amen.